All right, there's a lot to read, so hang in there with me. So Paly has two state champions. We have a football state champion, and we have a volleyball state champion. Let's get a round of applause for that. Let me list off the CCS titles. Football, volleyball, girls basketball, and boys baseball. Let's get a round of applause for all these folks. We also have a first in 25 years, and that is an SCVAL wrestling title for our wrestling folks on campus. Let's get a round of applause. We set national records with our swimmers this year. Let's give them a round of applause. Good job. And we are also sending some athletes to the state track meet, our 4x4 young folks. Tremaine Kirkman. 4x1. 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 Got it. Maurice Williams, Morris Gates Mouton, and Miles Anderson. Let's give them a round of applause. How many seniors do you think we have at Paly this year that are going on to play college sports? 30, 35. We have over 40 high school seniors from Palo Alto High School that are going on to play collegiate sports. That's tremendous. That's a wonderful accomplishment. That says two things about Palo Alto High School: that we have students and that we have athletes, and that's an unstoppable combination. Student athletes. Let's give everybody a round of applause. We have the honor of having MaxPreps here today. We have Megan Lothry from MaxPreps. Her title is the Volleyball Product Coordinator. And Megan, I'm going to turn this over to you to recognize our volleyball team.
Thank you. I'm very excited to be here today. I love giving volleyball awards. I'm a volleyball player. I got to play in college, and I know a couple of you guys are going on to do the same, so that's a great accomplishment. But back to the team, and this year, you guys had an outstanding season. They finished 41-1 and won the school's first girls volleyball state title, which is incredible. So give them a round of applause for that. It was a season of firsts for the volleyball squad: a Santa Clara Valley Athletic League De Anza Division title, a Central Coast Section Division I crown, the Northern California Championship, a state title, and a win against a national number one ranked team to do it, and a five-game thriller. Very exciting, very cool. The award we're here to give you today is the National Female Team of the Year Award. So on MaxPreps, we cover about 20,000 high schools. We cover 11 female teams, you know, girls basketball, girls volleyball, all those sports. So that's over 220,000 female teams that could have won this award. I'd love to tell you all the things you did, but I think Coach Dave Wynn can do you some more justice. I think he has a couple words to say. So I'll bring Dave Wynn up, the head girls volleyball coach.
Well, first I need the team to stand up, so everyone can really see it. Just come on, stand up. Last time I get to tell the seniors to do something. So I wasn't prepared to speak today, so for that reason it will be brief, and I know you all have to get back to school and you don't want to miss your next class. So suffice it to say, we had a great season. I'm not going to try to talk to the number of things we did, because there are many. We did have many goals this year. Winning this award wasn't one of them, but one of the things we'd like to talk about was, when you're doing something really good, the spotlight's going to shine on you. And when it shines on you, it not only shines on you as your team on the court, but you off the court, your whole school and your whole community. So it's nice that when the spotlight's shining, we're all doing something good. So it's not just about volleyball today. It is about the whole Paly program, all the great things the other sports have been doing. I mean, this has been a fantastic year. So it's nice to be able to celebrate this all with all you guys are doing great things too. But this team was amazing. You'd never want to say it'll never happen again, but even if it does, you can never have another first state title. So this group you're looking at here, they're part of history at Paly. I don't know if they're going to be in from Hall of Fame somewhere, build a building somewhere, or go for them, but all these people here did something that probably a lot of people thought was never going to be done at Palo Alto. So I just want to make sure that they get that respect. They all feel good about that. One last chance to say congratulations to this team, because it is a team effort. I am going to put the senior captains on the spot, because I want them to come up and give a few parting words. Because I promised I was going to keep this short today. So Megan and Trina, please. Just a few sentences about what it means to get a national award from MaxPreps, knowing that it's something that writers looked at all these other schools that Megan talked about and they picked us.
Well, first of all, thank you. Obviously, this is a huge award. I mean, going against 11 different sports, that's a pretty big deal and a huge honor. And I can only thank my other 17 teammates for helping me get along on this great journey.
Well, thanks for the award. We're very grateful.
And the microphone will be passed back to Phil. So thanks everyone for coming. Appreciate it.
One last big time round of applause. Anything we can do to top this off. I just want to say thank you to a number of people, to all the parents that came out to be supportive of the athletics and our great success this year, to the district who supported us in ways that parents didn't get a chance to see, to all of our staff that came out to games and helped supervise, and to all of you students for being so classy at Paly. I really, truly appreciate that. You represent the finest, and I very much appreciate that. We're going to have a great last 4 days. 3 days, depends on who you are. Have a wonderful rest of the day. We'll see you around.